most content. Oh, no, this one's okay. Always constantly. Sorry? Okay. Always constantly kind of reinvent yourself in terms of marketing strategy. I mean, works wise, yes. I mean, works in the case where every 3 to 4 years you can see probably like a bit of trends, but always stick to what you believe in. For me, what I believe in is capturing a lot of moments. So, with capturing moments, I mean, we can just see a trend right now recently, also a bit of the indie style, the hipster style. So, it's always a good match to follow a little bit on the trend, but still sticking to the point where it's capturing emotions. At the same time, marketing strategy, I think, is very important also. So, something like that, like, back then, 8 years ago, when I first started out, it was literally just StartSnap. I had my StartSnap account, just come out with posts, and I just advertised my story from there. But fast forwarding 8 years, not even 10 years, just 8 years, everybody has Instagram, and to be, it's a hard truth, right? For brands, they don't really read wedding magazines anymore. Because usually, I'm quite a curious person, and I always ask them, like, for example, my overseas trip, I would ask them, like, how do you find my people? How do you find old stories? And they always tell me through Instagram. So the thing is, right now, I felt that marketing strategy is always evolving, and it's not just Instagram, I think that's the main question also. Oh, sorry. Yeah. So the next, you know, way of, like, trying to propose stuff, I think that's very important. So, I believe, like, for blogging posts, right, or what I believe in is personality. So, the client wants to know, like, what kind of jobs are you? I mean, they know this company, yeah, this company has been, but who are the people inside and what do you like to do? What are your favorite food? What are you going to travel? So, at least when they meet you, I mean, the thought will express the same frequency that, oh, okay, I know that you just been to Hong Kong and, like, oh, you eat all these things, stuff and stuff. So, I felt that, to be honest, I mean, what I think is, personality, that's very important of the company. Then, I mean, your clients get you to compare or like, see different goals to feel that it has a kind of a very effortless, comfortable conversation together. Yeah, that's what I think about. I mean, the digital is social media right now, and you can see what else in the future we can write on.
Okay, so I belong to.
Okay, same like Jonathan, a bit of campaign shoots here and there. So if the wedding market is slow, then can do something else, you know, diversify a bit. Because that there will be always down period in wedding season, end of the year, start of the year, probably do something else. So always spread your mess.
Yeah, that's a very good advice. If something is not too smooth, you move on to another. Alright, since Ryan has nothing to add to this, we'll move on to the next one. Okay, there are many ways to skin a cat. So, what marketing strategies will work for you?
Okay, actually, I already kind of answered on number two, but yeah, so number two is kind of what I was going to say. For me, currently right now, marketing strategy is all about the social skills, social media. Like I said, Instagram right now is probably the most influential where they straight away just go to the phone at 10 p.m. before the big time. And they would just think about how people say, I just posted a photo of some other couple. So, my strategy for my company is I will always, I mean, not necessarily, you know, that they will get my service, but it's just like, okay, let me give you an example, just like this company, Apple, you know. Doesn't mean you know the company, I mean, the company is doing well, doesn't mean you need to own an iPhone, but at least you know that it's such a company. So, in future, with your clients, like, in the future, with your friends, hey, what phone is good? They say, oh, you can try iPhone, but it's about what you're doing Android, right? It's about the company in a way. So, for me wise, it's really all about putting myself out there and the company culture. I mean, like, for example, not only showing work. I mean, Instagram is quite cool right now, recently, that I think called post, please return post. So I did ask, like, the people who are viewing my Instagram, saying that, okay, if you're going to see my works, I mean, you can see my works really on the post itself. But what about the Insta stories, which is the video format? Would you want to see more photos, or would you want to see something different? Like, for example, if I'm in New Zealand, what food do I eat in New Zealand that I can recommend you guys? So most of them, almost like 85% to 90% say that, I want to see your food, what you recommend to go there and eat in New Zealand. I mean, I already see your photos on the post, so that's alright with me. So to me, how do I engage them, giving them, feeding them content? So in future, the long run, you know, like, I mean, right now, also, I have some friends telling me, you know, they're sending me, I mean, a thankful letter saying that, oh, I've been following you since the last year of my university days, and finally I'm getting married, because there are 8 years already. So, I'm glad I'm doing the service. So, in a way, giving a young crowd, like, when they're still studying, in future, when they, you know, come to get married, or decide to get married, at least they're back in their mind to think about this company. So, that's my strategy, for marketing, why. At the same time, I think also it's good to have very good relationship with other vendors like Boris, big artists and stuff. Yeah, because to me, if airlines, like Singapore Airlines, can create this thing called Star Alliance, you know, where they have other, like, for example, other airlines that come together and can put share, it's something to save for the wedding industry. In fact, I was thinking also like the problems to do that for like airlines. What if one day, you know, I might not be there for you because I got an accident? At least someone, you know, it's just like a plane. If the plane doesn't take off, at least another brand of the plane can take these plans off. Something like that. So I believe that being friends with your vendors is also very important where they can recommend you to your services. Yeah, at the same time, your own social media. That's what I think I'm recommending.
I'll try to be brief. I think we covered a lot of the new age, you know, Instagram, mass marketing. But I remember back when I was doing well as a developer, there were very select, I call them like star couples, and there were big proponents of my work, and they would market for me. And so the thing is, had I been more vigilant in my business, I would probably have created a stronger rapport with these people. So I even have couples who did not book me because of various reasons, like me pricing, they couldn't afford it. But they will still recommend their friends who got a bob king. And these are the really star, more direct, maybe type of marketing that you really should. I don't want to use the word exploit, but at least take advantage of. Obviously, you need to have a two-way work with your supporter, otherwise, they're not going to get you. So, while mass marketing is great because it gives you the volume, but there are people who can really do wonders for you. And it's not just your ex-clients, it could be alliances, your people that you work with.
They talk about the social media stuff. It's really important, social media now. So I don't repeat what they say because I also believe fully in that. Other than that, probably can do Google AdWords or those marketing. So Facebook ads, just to get more eyeballs, to get noticed. I mean, that's one form of marketing. Then also working together with maybe vendors, florists, and town designers, maybe collaboration to make it work together and to create content, because you have to show content so that show content so that people are interested in new social media. So giving content is important nowadays.
Okay, I think that's just about covering all the strategies. So we move on to the next one. Okay, times change. What your customers need 20, 30 years ago and right now is different. So what are couples looking for in their wedding business? Who shall answer first?
So what couples are looking for wedding? I mean, for the last 2 years right here, there's a huge change, to be honest. I mean, my partner here. So recently many clients are very looking at vendors, not only photographers, but vendors that have a very personal touch. That's the thing about my challenge right now, because to be honest, I mean, my company is a bit like mass market living in terms of marketing strategy. But at the same time, I'm also trying to be, at least be more personal with them. So what we are more personal, I mean, nowadays couples are looking at very customized stuff, like even the thank you cards and yeah, invitation cards is very handmade. So even their wedding also, they want it to be more intimate. Probably only maybe maximum 120 couples, That's what I see right now, is the one that you guys, but at the same time also giving like I said, the wedding is you want to make it very clear and meaningful right now. Yeah. Also much a bad friend.
What are they looking for? Actually depends on the target audience that you wanna get. For me, I think
So for me, couples come to me because of they want something unique, something different from the norm, based on what they see online, and what I can give them is something that's different. So they want something individual, customized to them, like what Melvin said, is unique in a sense where they don't see anywhere else. Some images that are not the run of the mill images. Then it's also the experience that they have during the shoot, so that they can look back and see years down the road they can laugh about it and talk about it. So it's an experience as well.
Okay, the next question could be a bit sensitive, but let's put it this way. Charges depends on a lot of situation. So the question of how much do you charge for 8 hours of show, can you just put it broadly? Don't have to pinpoint exactly, just broadly within the range. How much do you charge for 8 hours?
Okay, for me, 8 hours of the conceptualized shooting, it's 5,900 at that box. So.